Welcome everyone. Thank you for joining Town of North Hempstead 9/11 Remembrance Ceremony. We are here to honor and pay tribute to those who we lost September 11th. 22 years ago this day, the world stopped. We'll keep them and their families in our hearts. As our tradition continues at 8:46 a.m. and 9:03 a.m., we'll have a moment of silence. I would now like to call upon Albertson VFW Post 5253 to present the colors. Also, Nassau County Junior Firefighters to lead us with the Pledge of Allegiance. And the national anthem is sung by St. Mary's High School Chamber Choir. Please rise. Thank you.
Hand over your heart or hand salute, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proud twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming.
Color guard, please retire the colors. Please be seated, everyone. Our town of North Hempstead, town supervisor, Jennifer DeSena.
First, I want to thank town clerk Raghini Srivastava and her staff and the numerous other town departments that worked to make this morning of remembrance so special. Our annual commemoration of the September 11th attacks Our commemoration is a solemn occasion that calls upon us to remember, to reflect, and to honor the memory of those ripped from us on that faithful day. It's my honor to be here with you this morning as we come together as one town family to honor and cherish our loved ones lost that tragic morning 22 years ago. On September 11th, 2001, our nation faced an unprecedented tragedy, and nearly 3,000 innocent lives were lost, including over 400 police officers, firefighters, and other first responders who made the ultimate sacrifice trying to help and protect others and prevent further loss of life. Right here in our town, 56 of our friends and family members were torn from us that day, leaving an unimaginable void that can never be filled. Over the past 22 years, we have rebuilt, we have mourned, and as a nation, we have sought justice for the great evil that was perpetrated on our country. But we come together each year on this day, not to reflect on man's capacity for evil, but instead to honor those we lost and to thank ordinary citizens who became heroes that day. It was a day that tested our resolve and strength as a nation. And in response, we demonstrated that the American spirit could endure even the darkest of days. It's often said that time heals all wounds, but as many of us know, this is not necessarily true. And sometimes grief never fully fades in the face of such overwhelming tragedy. We gather today to give strength and support to those who need it, our families, friends, and neighbors who still bear this terrible burden of grief. As you continue to move forward in your journey, we vow to forever be by your side, and we will never stop celebrating the beautiful lives your loved ones led. Your loved ones meant so much not only to your family and friends, but to our town community as well. It is our sincere hope that all the surviving friends and family members who are here with us today find some solace and peace, knowing your loved ones are not forgotten and you are not alone in your grieving. In the years that have passed, thousands more have been tragically lost to the toxic legacy left behind by the attacks. We must also never forget those who have since succumbed to the 9/11 related cancers and illnesses, which still affect thousands more to this day. It's difficult to put into words the horrors we all witnessed on September 11th, 2001. As we look back on that terrible day and honor those we lost to these senseless acts, let the memory of September 11th serve as a reminder of our collective strength and determination. In the immediate aftermath of the attacks, we stood united as Americans, and this is something we should strive to recapture as we navigate these challenging and uncertain times. As we reflect on the 22nd anniversary of the September 11th attacks, let us renew our commitment to the principles of freedom, tolerance, and unity. Let us strive to build a future where such acts of hatred and violence have no place, and let us continue to draw hope from the memory of those lost that day. It is our solemn vow that we will forever be by your side, and as we ensure that we never forget. This is why we join today and every year. Thank you all for coming, and God bless America. Reverend Eddie Aline from the Cathedral of the Incarnation of Garden City for our invocation.
On the morning of September the 11th, 2001, 2,976 individuals from 93 nations lost their lives in New York, at the Pentagon, and on Flight 93. We remember the first time we heard the news. We recall the first time we saw those images. We remember the way our thoughts and prayers were with those families who lost loved ones. Our thoughts and prayers are with them again today. Let us pray. O God of comfort, though the years have passed, you are faithful still. Yesterday, today, and forever, let your love and peace endure. And we remember those who survived. We recall their heartbreaking stories. And we remember that their lives are forever scarred by those moments. Our thoughts and prayers are with them again today. O Creator and God of healing, though the years have passed, you are faithful still. Yesterday, today, and forever, let your love and peace endure. We remember the pain we felt. We recall the bereavement and bitterness of the aftermath. We remember that you are a creator of redemption and restoration. Help us forgive those who cause so much trauma, and that we may find release in that forgiveness. O God of forgiveness, though the years have passed, you are faithful still. Yesterday, today, and forever, let your love and peace endure. Remember that you love the world. We recall you sent your Son to bring reconciliation and salvation. Remember your Spirit inhabits your church. Help us bring your comfort and peace to all. O God of hope, though the years have passed, you are faithful still. Yesterday, today, and forever, let your love and peace endure. At this moment, we're just going to reflect and have that peace, that time of silence. May God bless us all, especially our first responders. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you. For the tragic events of 9/11, I was a young woman, filled with the promise of my own engagement, living miles apart and weeks away from making this country, this place, my new home. The moment I arrived, I witnessed thousands of mourners trying to uplift their lives from the devastation and horror of this unparalleled, senseless act of hate. I witnessed the grief of the families broken because of the loss of their loved ones. I witnessed the resilience, the courage of the individuals trying to move forward and helping others to move forward. We have taken a sacred vow to commemorate those who we lost and those who fought for our freedom. And today, as we all are gathered here to pay tribute, to honor our neighbors, our friends, families, a community that continues to heal. The ring of the bell feels deep in our heart. And it's a humblest request to everyone to help those whose lives changed forever. Do whatever you can. And also to a younger generation to learn the lesson of democracy, to help protect our freedom through peaceful means, dialogue, and communication. We all will stand together and will never forget. Thank you all. I also want to thank my colleagues in government for coming and supporting all of us, especially my town board members, council persons who will be coming here reading the names of the people we lost from their district. And a very special thank you to Erin McDonough, our bell ringer. Let me take a moment to recognize our town council member, Robert Triano, Peter Zuckerman, Dennis Walsh, Veronica Lovey, David Adami, Marian Delimonte, and we always already heard our supervisor, Jennifer DeSena. Now we'll start the memorial reading. Robert Triano.
From Westbury, we remember Michael Boyle, just 37. Richard George Buhert, 38. Thomas Patrick DeAngelis, 51. And my friend Wade Green, 42. We also remember those who grew up in Westbury, David Arce, Richard Aronow, my classmate, David Fontana, Ann McGovern, and former Mayor Westbury's son, Thomas Strada.
From Albertson, East Williston, Roslyn Harbor, and Roslyn Heights, we remember Robert J. Bearwalter, 44, Albertson. Michael John Cahill, 37, East Williston. Robert Joseph Foddy, 42, Albertson. Arlene Ava Freed, 49, Roslyn Heights. Michael Helmut Hobb, 34, Roslyn Heights. Peter J. Langone, 41, Roslyn Heights. Joseph Daniel Mayo, 32, Roslyn Harbor. Joseph E. Maloney, 45, Albertson. Raymond Marcus Neblett, 31, Roslyn Heights.
Councilman Dennis Walsh wasn't able to attend today, so I will read the names of our residents from District 3, Mineola, New Hyde Park, and Williston Park. We remember Janice Lee Blaney, 55, from Williston Park. Christopher Joseph Dunn, 28, from Mineola. Robert Thomas Jordan, 34, from Williston Park. Thomas Michael Langone, 39, from Williston Park. Michael Francis Lynch, 33, from New Hyde Park. Gerald Michael Alcott, 55, from New Hyde Park. Peter J. Owens Jr., 42, from Williston Park. Dipti Patel, 38, from New Hyde Park. Gregory Rita, 33, from New Hyde Park. John Anthony Spataro, 32, from Mineola. Mitchell Scott Wallace, 34, from Mineola. Donna Ann Wilson, 48, from Williston Park.
From Manhasset and Roslyn, we remember Rocco Camage, 60, from Manhasset. Paul Reagan Cassio, 23, from Manhasset. William A. Chelkoff, 41, from Roslyn. James Lee Connor, 38, Manhasset. Joseph Dermot Dickey Jr., 50, from Manhasset. Robert Douglas Eaton, 37, from Manhasset. Brett Owen Freeman, 29, from Roslyn. Stephen A. Giorgetti, 43, Manhasset. Robert R. Husa, 51, from Roslyn. Jeff Levine, 55, from Manhasset. Christopher Quackenbush, 44, from Manhasset. Donald Arthur Robson, 52, from Manhasset. Frank G. Salvaterra, 41, from Manhasset. Michael H. Seaman, 41, from Manhasset. Donald F. Spampinato, Jr., 39, from Manhasset. Matthew Gilbert Vienna, 23, from Manhasset. We also remember those who grew up in Manhasset, John Iskian and James Connor.
From Great Neck and New Hyde Park, we remember Christy Adamo, 28, New Hyde Park. Peter Christopher Frank, 29, Great Neck. Matthew James Grimalski, 34, New Hyde Park. Frederick Coe Jr., 53, Great Neck. Jennifer L. Howley, 34, New Hyde Park. Jonathan Lee Ielpe, 29, Great Neck. Richard Y. C. Lee, 34, Great Neck. Andrew Sergiopoulos, 23, Great Neck. Joshua S. Vitale, 28, Great Neck.
From Port Washington, we remember Neil James Cuttamore, 38, Port Washington. Timothy Colin Kelly, 37, Port Washington. Justin McCarthy, 30, Port Washington. Antonio Jose Rodriguez, 35, Port Washington. Ki Chaha Takahashi, 53, Port Washington. Dinah Webster, 50, Port Washington. We also remember those who grew up in Port Washington and my good friend, John Pepe Solano, Jr. We also remember two Port Washington Fire Department members who died in the line of duty due to 9/11 related illnesses. Robert Bobby Reese, Michael Muggsy Pickering.
And now I'd like to introduce Rabbi Pearl from the Chabad of Mineola.
This physical shofar is nothing more than the hollow horn of a ram. When the breath of a human being is blown through it, it undergoes a transformation. It becomes a living embodiment of the heart and the emotion of a human being expressing the divine self, sensing, pulsing within it, crying out to its maker. Today, it reminds us of the depth of the souls of all those lost at 9/11, and all of our inner desire to see a world of goodness and kindness with redemption for all. the 6,000 languages spoken in the world today, only one is truly universal, the language of tears. And that is the language we speak today. For 22 years now, we've shared these tears after the worst single peacetime act of terror we've ever known. And to all who lost loved ones, we say to you, your grief is ours. We feel it in our very bones. Right after the tragedy, we got together as a nation. We must not falter in the defense of what we aspire to, freedom, human dignity, religious pluralism, and mutual respect. Our approach to tragedy has always been twofold. One, on the one hand, we grieve. There's no way any human being can ignore the terrible and tremendous pain being suffered by so many people. However, we are not allowed to allow this grief to become all-consuming. We must turn this tragedy into triumph and ashes into rebuilding. We cannot allow those who would destroy us to be successful by being paralyzed by our sorrow. Let each of us find ways to add in positive acts of goodness and kindness, of charity and prayer. Fellow Americans, these vicious acts were heat-seeking missiles aimed at humanity's desire to fulfill its God-given mission on Earth, living in a peaceful and civilized manner. No, we will not allow our spirits to be broken. We will find the inner strength to rise above this black day in the history of our world. Today, our enemies have reminded us in the most devastating manner that all we have is each other and our shared desire to live in peace. We must stand together in a united front to protect our world. Let us unite through acts of goodness and kindness towards each other. May we merit this coming year to bring world peace and redemption. God bless America.
Thank you, Rabbi Pearl. Now I'd like to introduce Dr. Isma Chaudhry of the Islamic Center of Long Island for a few words. In the name of God, most gracious, most merciful. Good morning, dear friends and neighbors. We are here today to honor the memories of beautiful lives lost 22 years back on the horrific day of September 11, 2001. We do need to repeat it to ourselves because we learned so much that day and every day after that about our resilience, God's mercy, and God's blessings. It was over two decades back, but it feels like yesterday. That was the day when darkness tore our world apart. There are generations who will learn about 9/11 from textbooks. Most importantly, they learn from us. They will learn from the textbooks how 9/11 marked a day when the world changed. However, from us, they will learn how we as a nation emerged from intense grief and loss and faced the challenges of living in a post-9/11 world. Upholding the values of compassion, care, and love. From us, they will know the history of American resilience and resolve when faced with darkness of extremism. From us, they will know how to honor the legacy of heroes of 9/11. We lost innocent lives. We lost our brave men and women who answered to the call of duty and ran in as the towers were collapsing. Their selflessness and bravery will forever be etched in our hearts. We honor their sacrifice and the countless acts of kindness and compassion that followed. There was a lot that was lost that day. However, we emerged together as a nation with strength and dignity. And I wish and pray that we stay committed to remembering and honoring the heroes of 9/11 with earnest determination.
Now have a moment of silence.
I wish and pray that we... I wish and pray that we stay committed to remembering and honoring the heroes of 9/11 with earnest determination to reject extreme ideologies and make a promise every day that we will not let hate and bigotry or either any form of extremism win. Let's bow our heads and humble our hearts and pray. May God grant us the wisdom, will, and strength to love our neighbors and our communities as prescribed to us in divine scriptures. And may we open our hearts and minds to become each other's keepers. I pray that the lasting legacy of 9/11 is not fear, but hope and aspiration for a world renewed and transformed with compassion and kindness. Amen. Thank you.
I would now like to call upon Nassau County Controller, Elaine Phillips.
Good morning, everyone. So I'm going to read a poem today, When Great Trees Fall, by Maya Angelou. When great trees fall, rocks on distant hills shudder. Lions hunker down in tall grasses, and even elephants lumber after safety. When great trees fall in forests, small things recoil into silence, their senses eroded beyond fear. When great souls die, the air around us becomes light, rare, sterile. We breathe briefly. Our eyes briefly see with a hurtful clarity. Our memory, suddenly sharpened, examines, gnaws on kind words unsaid, promised, walks never taken. Great souls die in our reality, bound to them, take leave of us. Our souls, dependent upon their nurture, now shrink, wizened. Our minds, formed and informed by their radiance, fall away. We are not so much maddened as reduced to the unutterable ignorance of dark, cold caves. When great souls die, after a period, peace blooms, slowly and always irregularly. Spaces fill with a kind of soothing electric vibration, our senses restored, never to be the same, whisper to us. They existed. They existed. We can be, and be better, for they existed. May God bless the men and women that serve this country. May God bless the men and women that served our country. And may God bless the United States of America.
Thank you, Elaine Phillips. I would like to invite St. Mary's High School Chamber Choir for America the Beautiful.
Thank you.
Thank you. I also want to recognize and thank our receiver of taxes, Charlie Berman. I just noticed he's here. Thank you so much. Now is the time to present the wreath. We present the wreath to those who made the ultimate sacrifice and to those who continue to fight for our freedom. I would like to invite for the wreath presentation, Sergeant Stephen Krakowski from Nassau County Police Department, ex-chief Brian Watterson, Port Washington Fire Department, Chief Mike Farron, Manhasset Lakeville Fire Department, Chief Jeff Loriano, Roslyn Fire District, and Chief Tim Stellato, Carl Place. Also, I call on Elberson VFW Post 5253 for taps and rifle salute.
Detail, present off. Detail, order off. Order left, sir.
As we come to the conclusion of our programs, Michael Tedeschi with inspirational and motivational music. I thank you all for joining. May God bless United States of America. Thank you.